Section 4. You will hear a talk given by a professor about the history of mines in Australia. First, you have some time to read through questions 14 to 19. Now listen carefully and answer questions 14 to 19.
Today, I'd like to explore a topic that is of increasing importance to the economy here in Australia, mining. I'll start by getting into how mining developed and look at how it's progressed into the multi-billion dollar industry it is now. In the late 1700s, as you know, Australia was first colonised by the British. And life here was rough at first. There was no industry on the continent and very little in the way of agricultural production. Then, in the mid-1800s, everything changed. Silver was the first precious metal discovered, and a few years later, lead deposits were found. In 1851, the real boom began because gold was found in New South Wales and Victoria. A gold rush immediately followed, which caused the Australian population to triple within a decade, and the country's economic fortunes would rely heavily on the mining industry thenceforth. The mining boom of the 1900s, the one we're still currently experiencing, is a direct result of exploration in the Pilbara, a region in Western Australia. The resources in that area were first accessed by pioneering businessmen Lang Hancock during the early 1950s. Hancock founded a company named Hancock Prospecting, which is now one of the major mining corporations in the Pilbara. The main resource companies were mining in Pilbara was iron ore, and that's significant because that iron ore was used in the production of steel, which is important for buildings, cars, roads, railways, and ships. At first, the vast majority of Australia's iron exports went to the West. But in the 1990s, there was a shift in international trade. China began opening up its economy and becoming more capitalist, and its rapid industrial and manufacturing growth has created a huge demand for raw materials like iron. From the early 2000s onwards, it became the biggest importer of Australian iron in the world. In fact, over the first 10 years of the millennium, China's demand grew so much that 70% of Australia's iron ore is now sent there. Now, before I talk about some of the other major industries integral to the Australian economy, let's look closer at the major mining companies that are found here.
You now have 15 seconds to check your answers.